So if God is responsible for everything that happens in the world, then why does he make people do evil things?
Same thing, you see. I told you, necessary time to jump from personality to principle or to Hinduism, these kind of questions will arise in different guises. So the question was, in a way, sent to me by email saying, Ms. Lakhani, suppose someone does bad karma, but you said God is in charge of whatever happens, then of course the poor man is not responsible. So why should he suffer? Because he did bad karma because God didn't sort him out or didn't produce the right person. So please, why do we blame him? See, this thing, personality-oriented Hinduism or personality-oriented tradition, any religion is in trouble straight away because you cannot answer this blunt question. I just lighten up. If you ask in the Abrahamic tradition, why is this suffering, you know, they would say, oh, see, before this silly man, Adam, took a bite of the apple, everything was pristine. All the animals were living with each other happily. Of course, not eating each other. I don't know how they survived. And everything was pristine and pure, and there was no pain and no suffering. It's only when this man ate the apple, trouble. Pain started, suffering started. It's all human being. You are the culprit. That's why now your sins have to be absorbed by will to crucify Christ. See, you can see flies in the face of common sense and science. And this is how. So, personality-oriented tradition, every tradition is a big big trouble when you take on the challenges from science and rationality. That's why Richard Dawkins loves to rub it in. So we have to jump from the personality to principle, saying that personality is a wonderful tool to use to engage with this deeper vision of principle-oriented Hinduism. But when the challenges come, we jump back on the principle-oriented Hinduism to respond. So the response is this. It says, my friend, the underpinning, which is the spirit and pure and pristine, not even God, just call the word spirit, Brahman. When it manifests itself, becomes visible as a creation, is in trouble. It has to pay a tax, if I can use this kind of word. We love the word tax. We don't love it, by the way.
Mm.
So the tax has to pay the tax. The tax is suffering. Unfortunately, the moment the spirit takes on a form, even an amoeba or whatever, bacteria or a human being, the poor thing has to pay a tax. The tax is suffering.
Mm.
It comes with the territory, unfortunately. So, but you say, why does he bother to do it? I say, I don't know. He should have stayed alone and not bothered to create all this creation. The answer will not be, it's not answered. It was simply not because we are running away, because the why and when comes with the creation. So we don't know exactly how the blasted thing started off. So we say spontaneous creation, why we can't answer. But then when it becomes visible, it gets into trouble. And then you can answer all these questions. Why is somebody doing bad things to pay a price? Because he's caught up now. And that is the way we respond. Jump from personality to principle whenever, not just doing for the fun of it, whenever it will give you better handle, because we are not talking nonsense. Principle-oriented has the answer same as science, perhaps better than science.